My name is Denise Gallant, and this is the Synopsis Video Synthesizer.
The original circuits in the system were designed between 1974 and 78 by Rob Schafer, initially at UCSC, under the guide of Gordon Mumma and the Electronic Music Studio. We experimented with manipulating video signals by mixing Moog oscillator signals with video during live music video concerts at UCSC.
And so I said, don't track the
TV viewer fades in and out.
Like dreams I've had lately, I can't really imagine them happening. Dreaming a painting and then walking inside the painting.
Many of our concepts of video art were experiments in how to integrate audio and video into synesthesia-like experiments, which became a central and unique component of the video synthesizer. Rob also created a circuit to allow audio to trigger or mix video between a live signal and tape, editing video to sound in real time. Another core component of the video synthesizer was the colorizer. We worked primarily with black and white cameras at that time, so Rob designed a video colorizer as the heart of the system. What is unique about the colorizer is that it produced 720 degrees of color, rather than a standard 360 degrees of color, which allows rainbow-like hues to be added to the video signal. Another unique non-traditional module was the concept of an 8-channel luminance keyer. If we plug a video signal into the keyer, the light level can cut off segments of the video. The light areas are one channel and the dark areas are another channel, with layers of gray channels in between. On each of these channels, I can adjust the luminance, saturation, or hue, rather than the typical RGB, which is much more difficult to control in live situations, and typical of all other video synths.
So here's the colorizer, and then it's being controlled by this 8-level keyer. So I'm actually adding in the luminance, the saturation, and the hue. What's unique about this colorizer is about 10 things, and one of them is just that you control luminance, saturation, and hue rather than RGB, which was something I really wanted to do because I wanted to run this in live concert situations where I have music coming in affecting the graphics. At any point, I could just flip a switch and go over to blue and I'm okay, because blue always looks good.
I could plug in multiple inputs into each channel, mixing real video signals and oscillator patterns. We can also invert the luminance, saturation, and hue of each channel. You can also plug the oscillators into the video input and have the oscillators cut the key levels. In this case, I have a triangle waveform as the key input, where I can set 8 separate channels of video.
What I have here is this oscillator, which is actually a triangle oscillator, like that, cutting off the different layers of the key. I could probably get all 8 of these if I finally tune them.
One of our goals was to be able to run the video in live concert settings, so the 8-level keyer included small LED lights to show which channels are active. Rob also created a variety of high-frequency oscillators that were built into the system, which could be locked to video frequency. The horizontal and vertical triangle, square, or circular or parabola oscillators could be added together in a variety of patterns. The audio control comes from our only third-party module in the system, A gentle electric pitch follower allows the pitch or amplitude of the audio to voltage control modulate any input on the synthesizer, such as patterns, color, or luminance.
Now, the other thing that's unique about it is that it's voltage controllable. So I could have the video, the patterns, the oscillators, or music with a pitch follower control anything on this system. And so this is the first time a pitch follower has been built into a video synthesizer.
When we were building this system in Berkeley and San Francisco in 1978 and 79, we were also testing the system in local clubs in San Francisco, Berkeley, and Santa Cruz. The clubs were always dark, and only two levels could be used with the low luminance tube black and white cameras of that time. Also editing at NBC LA in 1977 and 78. In 1980, I came back to LA with the video synth with the hope of getting work in special effects and in those pre-MTV early years of music videos. Boom, 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 boom. The budgets for music videos were huge for well-known bands, but nearly non-existent for upcoming bands in Los Angeles. It was the early experimental new wave bands that seemed to appreciate the video synth most. Along with avant-garde producers such as Kim Fowley and Rene Dalder.
We now can finally begin to enjoy the fruits of our age-long, painful labors.
I was also the first VJ in Los Angeles, creating live video in a number of popular clubs. However, it was the movie industry that paid our rent. We created effects for several movies, including the infamous Brainstorm with Natalie Wood and Christopher Walken. One of Rob's later modules that was added to our system in 1981 was a four-level keyer mixer, creating unique extra soft keys between four video signals. This new soft look also worked well with the growing new age music market. We were contacted with early new age music artists such as Steve Roach and Richard Bermer. And later with the popular German New Age group, Tangerine Dream. I was also introduced to Brian Samuels, a laser artist who became a three-year partner. Brian's ARP audio synthesizer was used to create gorgeous laser-like patterns on a medical oscilloscope, which I then captured with the black and white camera, adding patterns, colors, and video channels to the signal. One of the results of this collaboration was a 16-song video compilation called Watercolors, which won a 1986 Billboard Music Award.
Inside the august marble walls of the Kennedy Center, there's some strange goings-on today. The beginning of a five-day video festival. Take a look. Do not adjust your TV set. There is nothing wrong. This is just one aspect of the brave new world called video.
I also won an AFI grant during those years, creating a children's pilot wrapping the video effects around a story. In 1985 and 86, I joined the high-end video effects studio Image West, which had the very early Scanimate analog computer. Along with our other high-end commercial work at Image West, I was able to stay late at night, creating similar laser-like patterns for my own video art projects. In 1986, I came back to Santa Cruz and married Kevin Monahan, who is also from the high-tech audio industry and had been at EMU Systems for 20 years. While I worked on the more technical side with companies such as Chiron, Discrete Logic, and SGI, we continued with our video art projects, including the first special effects CD-ROM, which we called Nightclub Earth. We still create video art, often integrating the Synopsis Video Synth effects for dance, sculpture, Las Vegas stage shows, music video art.
This is dedicated to the one I love.
Backgrounds for music theater, and video for large screen projections such as the yearly NAMM TEC Awards show in Anaheim. And as you see here, after over 35 years, the video synth is still working, as recently demonstrated at a showing in San Francisco.
Go.
Sweet!
That is a lot of fun.
Hello.
So we can change the colors?
Yeah.
This is so cool.
Rob, who has worked as an engineer with CBS for the past 30 years, has also recently created a new HD video synth for the next generation of video artists.
It's an album cover.
If you would like to see more examples of our work, please visit our YouTube channel, Video 4 Archive, or our webpage at video4creative.com.